Hello, this is Chris Charles, Everyday VBA. In this video, we're going to continue down the array route. We're actually going to look at Lbound and Ubound array. We have some arrays here. This is the code that we have rolling. And I just want to go over what Lbound and Ubound is. Now, this is going to be an overview. This may actually be kind of boring. However, this will make your life so much easier when we get to the new videos. So quite simply, I've got two different arrays here. And all I'm going to do is I'm going to go debug.print, okay? Because I'm going to print these. I'm going to print what these are, right? So I'm going to go ubound, uarray, okay? And if I do this, what's going to happen when I print this, it's going to print the upper bound, which happens to be 20. And since I don't have a caveat in there or a index, it's going to give me that first one. So if I wanted to do the second one, and again, trust me, when you get to doing loops with these things, your world will change. So this is definitely foundational stuff. So ubound array is the second, right? So essentially that's going to be the upper bound. It's going to give me, what it's going to give me is it's going to give me 10. So the difference with ubound and lbound, quite simply, if we copy these bad boys, we print, and we change this to L. And I did this for different arrays, so all right, we got LL. So ubound is the upper bound, lbound is the lower bound. So if you think about this, well, it makes sense. Now, why would you have an array that went from 10 to 20? I don't know. Typically, you're going to start at 0 or 1. Why would you have it from 5? Again, don't know. But this gives you the lower bound. So this L bound is going to be of the index of 1. And this is just so you know, this is identical to this, right? So if I click F8, it's going to give me the lower bound of 10, which is that guy. It's also going to give me the lower bound of the second, which is going to be 5. You will also notice that your L bound and U bound is going to match perfectly. If we did U bound of oarray, it would give us 3. If we did U bound of L bound, it would give us 0. So let's do that real quick. Now it's one dimensional, so it's not going to, we actually don't need to put anything else. If we did, it's going to give us an error. So we're going to go U and then L. We get rid of this because it doesn't make sense. And we're going to print those out. Again, foundational stuff, not the most exciting. So U bound is going to give us 3. L bound is going to give us, if you put in the right array, I found that when you code, it only does what you tell it to. Again, it's going to give you 0. So you'll notice if we were to do the L bound and U bound, now in a two-dimensional array, it's going to have 1, and then it's going to go from 1 to 10. That is L bound and U bound. Again, foundational stuff. You will love this when we get to converting ranges or copying ranges into arrays and then using loops to go through them. This is well worth your time. Hope you enjoyed.